Omnivore is my new favorite read it later app, and in this video, I'll do a walkthrough of the app. I'll tell you my three favorite features, and at the end of the video, I'll show you a comparison chart between Omnivore versus Readwise versus Pocket versus Instapaper. So let's get started. So Omnivore is a free and open source read it later app. Read it later apps have a basic function. They let you save an article and read it for later. They also remove all the distracting elements from the website, so you can just focus on having a really great reading experience. This app is available on the web, iPhone, iPad, Android, and it has a really robust Chrome extension, which I'm gonna show you in a moment. So here's what the app looks like. On the left panel here, you'll see the inbox, and this is where any new article that you save goes into. This includes any newsletters, RSS feeds, as well as any PDFs, and we'll talk about that feature in a moment. But this is the inbox. Continue reading is any article you've started to read, so anything that's in progress. Any non-feed items, so this is your traditional articles you've manually clipped from the internet. And then we have your highlights, so any highlights from recent articles are all here. You can click on them and see all the different highlights and notes. Any articles that are unlabeled or don't have a tag to them, oldest first, and then these are files. So anything that's like a PDF that you want to save, you can also include that into Omnivore, which is one of the cool features. You have archive, and then you're able to also save searches. This is actually a big save searches menu. So I have James Clear here, and I have all the kind of a tag I'm using for his articles that I want at the top. And then you have subscriptions. So any sort of subscription you have, a newsletter or an RSS feed is here. And then these are your tags or your labels for different articles. And any article can have multiple tags in them. So that's the panel. And then over here, we have just to be able to view it on tile style for the articles or list view. I like list view here. And this is just the settings. And you can go to dark mode, light mode, things like that. Now let's go into an article here. And you can see if I scroll all the way up to the top, we have this article here from Morgan Housel. I've tagged it as a finance article. And then over here, you can add any additional tags to it. So we can remove the finance tag. And let's say I want to create a new tag. I can do life lessons. And I can create that as a new tag. And now it's life lessons here. And then here is where you can look at all of your highlights. So as you highlight more things, you can have this panel here and see all of them. You can also add notes to the entire article. We have some information on the article. You can edit the metadata, delete the article, and archive it right there. And then over here, you have your accessibility settings here. You can increase the font size. You can change the font, you can do the margins, line height, and then also background for the reading experience. Okay, so that's what the app looks like. Now let me tell you about my three favorite features and why I love this app so much. So my first favorite feature of Omnivore is its Chrome extension. I'm on James Clear's website, and there's an article here called "The Ultimate Productivity Hack is Saying No." So I wanna save this article, and I'll go up to the Chrome extension here, and I'll click on that, and you'll see the options I have. It saves it, and then I can also add a note here. So a note about the article. I can go ahead and set a label or a tag. I can read the article now, which I really like. A lot of these apps, the read later apps, don't want to just kind of quickly go into the article and just read it and remove all the clutter. And then you have some other features here as well, where you can edit the title, you can archive it right away, and you can delete it. So it all is available right as you click on the Chrome extension. So I think it works really, really well. So here is the article we just saved. So if we click into it, we can see that it's removed all the clutter. If we want to go to the original, we can click on that. But it's given us the article in its purest form. And this is where my second favorite feature of the app comes, which is the ability to take notes and highlight to your heart's content. This is basically a paid feature if you use Pocket or Instapaper, and it works really, really well. Highlight something and you can color code that highlight. You can also add a note with that highlight. So if we just color code it here, and if we go into the notebook here, we can see our highlight. And the really cool thing is you can add a tag to a specific highlight. So it's not just to the article, but it's to a specific highlight. And I really like this because if you read articles, a lot of times there's different topics that you wanna kind of capture and remember that specific label. And for me, I really like using the tag phrase. Sometimes it's a really good phrase that I like, and I wanna steal it for my writing. So I like using that as a label, and I can go back to that later on. Now, if I go back to my main page here and I just archive this, So now if I go into archive and I go into the phrase label, you could see that the ultimate productivity hack is saying no shows up. I don't have a tag labeled for the article, but you can see over here, this other article I have does have a tag of productivity. But if I click into it and I go into the notebook, you could see this is where that phrase tag is located. And it's only for this specific highlight, which I really liked. So my third favorite feature is the ability to subscribe to a newsletter through Omnivore and not use your own personal email address. So if you go up here to your settings, you can go into emails. And the cool thing is you can set up a unique email address and create a bunch of different unique email addresses, copy it, and we'll go back to this newsletter called Installer from The Verge, and I can paste in that specific email address, sign up, and it says, thanks for signing up. And then if I go back to Omnivore and I go back to the main page here, you could see Welcome to Installer. So it acts that welcome email. And there's information here. You can also unsubscribe here. You can also confirm your subscription, but it's all done through the app, which I think is really cool to have your newsletters through Omnivore and not use your personal email address. Because a lot of times those newsletters are just articles, right? I still like the idea of having a separate email address for certain types of newsletters that are more visual that I think Omnivore doesn't do as well as any promos. If you're interested in having a separate email address, I have a video here that I'll link up about having a separate email address for your newsletters, which I think is a great idea. The other thing I like about Omnivore is the files feature. So you can add PDFs into Omnivore and they will work pretty well. So any PDFs you have, any documents you can grab in here, you can put in here and you can save, and it works the same way where you can highlight and you have your notebook as well. Some additional random features that I really like about Omnivore is if you do Command K, if you're on a Mac, you can quickly go through different elements of the app. So continue reading. And if I do Command K here, I can go to unlabeled, I can go to files. So it's really handy with the keyboard shortcuts. I also like, and I know this is pretty simple, but if I go back to my inbox and I go to this welcome installer, I click on that, I can easily delete a article. And a lot of times like Instapaper or Pocket, like they have you, like they basically prompt you to delete again, but this automatically deletes it and there's an undo feature. But I really like that it's a single trash or single delete button. A lot of times when you're saving things, you mess up and you want to delete something really quickly, it does that quite well. You can also integrate Omnivore into your note-taking app or your second brain. It works for Logseq and Obsidian. I'm a Notion user. That feature I believe is coming sometime in the future, but it would be able to sync all of your highlights into your note-taking app, which I think is a really cool idea, and hopefully that comes soon. So as I promised, here's a comparison between Omnivore, Pocket, Instapaper, and Readwise. I know there's an app called Matter out there, and I haven't used it in a while, so I didn't want to do that comparison. But I think when it comes to Omnivore versus Pocket and Instapaper, it is easily a much better app. And I think the big thing about Omnivore is that it's free for searching, highlighting, taking notes, and tags, which are all sort of premium or limited features on Pocket or Instapaper. So if you're on the basic free version of Pocket and Instapaper, I think it's a no-brainer to move over to Omnivore. And they do have tools to move all of your articles to the service. Readwise, I think, is a great app. It's obviously $8. So if you don't care about those bells and whistles that the app has, and you're not really focused on like on the book side of it and just focus on reading on the internet and short form articles, I think Omnivore is a better solution. But this chart here goes through all the different features that I think are relevant. The two features that I think are really cool that I still want from the app are one, send a Kindle feature. I love reading on my Kindle and not being on my computer or my iPad. And then the second is Notion integration, which I think will happen relatively soon, but be able to integrate all the highlights into my note-taking app would be an amazing feature to have. But I think if Omnivore keeps its core features of highlights, tags, notes, and search as free features, which I think should be the case, then I think this is the app to have and to keep because it it does those things really well. And that's kind of the core function in my mind of a good Read It Later app. So let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Take care of yourself and I'll see you in the next one.